Well, welcome to the Outpouring broadcast, and I'm your host, Bishop Corletta J. Vaughn, and I'm telling you, I'm so excited. Don't you just love that opening song? The Holy Spirit is moving in the earth today as never before, and you don't want to miss this. You want to be a part of the Outpouring. So I welcome you. I'm so glad that you're here with me. And we are studying God the Holy Spirit for the rest of the year, for the rest of your life. You want a relationship with God the Holy Spirit. And so oftentimes we have known Jesus Christ as our personal Savior, and we have made a great deposit in the earth by spreading the good news about Jesus Christ. But I want you to know that there was a promise given to us by the Father that was manifested through Jesus about the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is the partner. He's God with Jesus and the Father to produce the kingdom in the earth today. So you don't want to miss. You don't want to miss any part. You know that Jesus Christ came to save us from our sins. And that's good news. And that's really, really good news. But Jesus Christ also gave us access. He gave us access to everything that the Father originally promised. So don't touch that dial. You are in the right place with Bishop Vaughn, and we're going to be talking about God, the Holy Spirit. Would you do me a favor? Would you call a neighbor? Would you call a friend? Would you even call an enemy and say, hey, listen, you got to watch this. You have got to hear this. There is information that you need to know to make the journey a more easier journey in life, and it's learning about God, the Holy Spirit. And I guarantee you, they will not be disappointed. Now, they may just be disappointed if you don't call them and tell them that we're here. So do that, won't you please? We're here every week, and we're going to be right here teaching on God, the Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Father, we so appreciate you. And we are so in love with you. And we thank you so much for what you have done for us through your Son, Jesus. And we thank you that even now, Jesus, you are the baptizer of the Holy Spirit. And we want to be saturated. We want the outpouring of your Holy Spirit in our lives. I ask that the eyes of our understanding would be enlightened, that while the Holy Spirit teaches us, that we will receive it. Bless those that are viewing. Bless those that are listening. And we give you praise for the advantage that's coming in their life. In Jesus' name, amen. Are you ready? All right, let's get our Bibles. Now we want to go back to our teaching about the intimacy that you can have with the Holy Spirit. I want to give you a little testimony about me. It was maybe now 40 years ago that I really desired to have a relationship with Jesus. And I wanted Jesus to tell me about this Holy Spirit. I didn't know what I was asking. But I really fallen in love with the Lord as a young child. I preached my first sermon at 4 years old. And I was preaching too. I was really preaching. And I was singing and I was playing, and tears would always come out of my eyes. And so I always had a sensitivity to the Lord. When I got to be about 9 years old, we had something called summer revival. And in our affirmation, you had to sit on the mourner's bench when you got to be a certain age, and the mothers of the church or your mother would sit there with you. That Friday night in that revival, I gave my heart to Jesus Christ. And it was the greatest, oh God, it was the greatest thing. And I remember walking up there, the band had been preaching about Paul, a fool on a mule in the middle of the road. I never will forget it. And I was the last person on the mourner's bench. So my mom was sitting right behind me. And he came down and he walked and said, is there anyone that wants to be saved? Well, I was the only one left. And my mother said, as she leaned up in my ear, she said, you do. And in that moment, Jesus came into my heart. So for a long time, I was just happy with Jesus alone. I was so satisfied, and I read my Bible, and I was just saturating myself in my relationship, my newfound relationship with Jesus. But then after I got to be a teenager, I ran into some real serious troubles. As a teenager growing up and, you know, being pulled on by friends. And I realized that as much as I loved Jesus, I didn't seem to have any power. So I began to ask my parents about this power. I said, you know, I really wish I had something more. I wish there was something more. And my mom said, well, keep reading your Bible. The Lord's going to speak to you. And then I went to my dad, and my dad was at this point a minister. And I said, Dad, I love Jesus with all my heart. I love the Father. I said, but is there something else? I keep reading in the Bible about the Holy Spirit. And my dad said, well, honey, I don't know much about this Holy Spirit that you're talking about. He said, but keep reading. He said, the Lord will bring you the revelation that you need. They were very open. And at that time, I was a musician, so I played for different churches and played for different choirs. And I kept seeing different faiths, different reformations, worship differently. I grew up Baptist, and so we had a traditional shout the way we received the Lord. When we were happy, we would get happy, and the ushers would come in and take us out. But as I began to travel to different churches, I began to see a different display, and I wanted it. I wanted it. I began to hear the noises and the sounds. And being on the instrument, I could look out in the congregation and I could see people literally ecstatic because something was happening with them. And I began to hear the noises. I began to hear the sounds. And I would ask questions and people said, oh, they're speaking in tongues. And I didn't know what that was. I'd seen it in the Bible, but I didn't know what it was. And so I really began to search and search and search until I began to get some answers. And I remember I had gone to this Pentecostal church. It was a Kojic church. And the bishop was preaching so, and I was on the organ playing, and God was moving in the atmosphere. And they began to really just, exuberantly just praise God. And one woman began to say in tongues, and then she began to interpret tongues. I know the language now. I didn't know it then. And she began to prophesy. And I said, oh, wow, I've never seen this before at all. And I asked the question. I said, well, what happened in the service? I asked the bishop. And he said, oh, those are the gifts of the Holy Ghost. I said, the Holy Ghost has gifts. You see, I was like many of you. I didn't know about the Holy Spirit. I had seen his operations in the book of Acts and throughout the scriptures, but I didn't know what to call it. I didn't even know that there was a Holy Spirit. I didn't even know that he could be that powerful and potent in our lives. And to then find out that he had gifts, oh my goodness. And I was singing in a choir, and I was assistant director for another choir. And they were having Bible study at a woman's house on a Tuesday night. I never will forget. It was Mother Woodard. And it was down in her basement. And her pastor had given these five women permission to have a Bible study because at that time they couldn't do it in the church. And I went one Tuesday. And they were talking about the Holy Ghost. And as they were talking about the Holy Spirit, my hunger, my thirst, my appetite, it became increasingly intense. And I went back the next Tuesday. And then I kept going and I kept going. I told my mom, I told my dad, my husband. I had two small children at the time. And I began to tell everybody because it was satisfying something in me that I wasn't getting in my local church. And I remember the night my mom and my dad said, we're going to go with you because we want to make sure that you're not in a cult. I said, Ma, it's not a cult. They're talking about Jesus, but they're talking about God, the Holy Spirit. It doesn't matter what you say, we're coming. So this particular night, everybody loads up. My husband's there. My small child, who I just birthed, was about 2-3 months old. She's laying across my lap. My older child, she's sitting next to me. Behind me is my dad and then my mom directly there. And then on the other side, there was another lady. So they began to sing and they began to teach. And while they were teaching on the Bible, one of the young women got up and said, I have a word from the Lord. Well, I was just captivated by this now. I'm hooked. And she said, I have a word from the Lord. Well, now I've learned the language. So I knew there was a prophecy coming forth. And she said, the Lord would say that if you would praise me, that I will fill you with the Holy Spirit. Oh, I can feel it now. 40 years later. And she said, begin to praise me. Begin to praise me. The Holy Spirit is going to pour out tonight like never before. So in my church, we would shout, but that wasn't what she said. She said, praise me. So on this side of me, there was a lady, and she began to say, hallelujah. And because I'd gone to other reformations, I knew hallelujah was praise. And I began to say, hallelujah. I began to say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And about that time, the smoke and the intensity filled that room. And by that time, this woman behind me began to speak in tongues. And as she began to speak in tongues, I said, oh, I want those tongues so bad. And she was just speaking and speaking, and she was speaking so. And as she was speaking, I was becoming more and more perturbed because I wanted it to be me. About 2 hours later, they tapped me on my shoulder and they said, Corletta, you've got it. It wasn't her, it was me. All that time, I thought it was someone else, it was me. He gloriously filled me with the Holy Spirit. And I spoke in tongues, I couldn't stop speaking. I couldn't stop speaking. The people would just, the more they would praise, it's like he would fill me again. But I had been searching for this Holy Spirit for a long time. They took me out of the door. They had to carry me. My husband had to carry me out the door. And my mom, she was next to me. She was just happy. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. They got me home. I spoke in tongues all night. And then I prophesied to my husband. Then I began to speak things futuristically, and God just filled me. The next morning, I couldn't go to work. When the phone rang, someone was calling. I picked up the phone. I was still speaking for 3 days and 3 nights. I spoke in tongues, and the Lord spoke to me in the midst of that. This is 1974, and said to me, I've called you to preach the gospel. You will preach. You must preach. And do not be afraid of what they say. All of this happened in a 3-day period, 72 hours. I went from being saved, loving Jesus, loving God the Father, to now being gloriously filled with the Holy Spirit. Oh, I feel him right now. Maybe somebody is watching right now and you need this same experience. See, the last time we were together, I spoke to you about Catherine Kuhlman and how she was pleading, do not hurt my friend. He is my closest, most intimate. He is my most precious friend. He's all I have. And that's what stirred Benny Hinn. But I thought maybe this time I would give you my testimony. And ever since that wonderful day, the Holy Ghost has become my closest, my most intimate friend. So I want to introduce to you, my friend, God, the Holy Spirit. And I want you to know that you can know him the way I know him and better. You can fellowship with him in such a powerful way that he becomes your closest, most intimate friend. And when we come back from the break, I'm going to talk to you more about my friend, God, the Holy Spirit. Don't move. I'll be right back.
Would you join us in prayer Monday through Friday at 6 a.m. Word Wednesday, every Wednesday with Bishop Vaughn at 6 a.m. The teleconference number is 805-399-1200. The conference acceptance code is 870-507-pound. Be sure and put the pound.
Well, thank you so much for coming back. Now, let's go on a journey together. We're talking about God, the Holy Spirit. Now, I can hear some of you say, well, what about Jesus? What about Jesus? Well, I want to tell you something. And I want you to join me in St. John's Gospel. And as I was preparing for today, this is what the Holy Spirit spoke to me. And I want to share this with you. He said, stop making a rivalry where there is none. What does that mean? There is no rivalry between God the Father, God the Son, or God the Holy Spirit. He said, stop making a rivalry where there is none. All right? So there is no rivalry between God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. I want you to write that down. There's no rivalry. Number two, there is no superiority. They are equal. There is no inferior God. There is no superior God. There is no lesser God. There is no greater God. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. They are one. They are equal. They operate in different seasons and different dispensations very differently. But they are not striving with one another. They are not fussing with one another. When you say, oh, thank you, Jesus, the Holy Spirit and the Father, they don't get mad. When you say, thank you, Father, Jesus and the Holy Spirit, don't go in a corner and pout. And when you say, oh, hallelujah, Holy Spirit, Jesus does not say, how dare you? So get that out of your mind. There is no rivalry between the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now I'm going to show you some scripture that will back that up. Would you join me in John chapter number 14? And this is when Jesus was about to leave the earth, and he's preparing his disciples and he's sharing with them, you know, what is to come. He gives us some very important information. And this is what he says. John chapter number 14, the Gospel of John. And I want you to go with me to verse 16. He says, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper that he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he will dwell with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. A little while and you will not see me anymore. But because I live, you will also live also. Now, Jesus is preparing them for his departure. And then he's giving them more and more information about who he's going to leave or who is coming to replace his physical presence. All right. John chapter number 16. Now, this is still the same conversation. Although it's divided in chapters, but it's the same conversation with the same folk. He says now in verse 5, but now I go away to him being the Father, who sent me, and none of you ask, where are you going? But because I've said these things to you, sorrow fills your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. You got to mark this. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you. Now watch this, verse 12. I, Jesus, still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. However, when he, the Holy Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth, for he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you the things to come. He will glorify me, for he will take of what is mine and declare it unto you. For all things that the Father has are mine. Therefore, I say, he will take from what is mine and declare it unto you. Okay, now let's talk about this. So the Holy Spirit is coming. And Jesus says that if you try to hold me here, it's not going to work out for your good. Because my moment is finished. Now, the next part of God must come. And he is God, the Holy Spirit. So he's going to pick up from where I've left off, and he is going to give you the advantage. Listen to what it says. He said, it is for your or to your advantage that I go away. Wow. So now that I have received Jesus as my Savior, now I must make room for the Holy Spirit. Yes, there is the indwelling at salvation. Yes, my relationship begins then. When I believe the gospel, I hear the gospel, I accept Jesus Christ. The Bible says at that moment, praise God, that I receive the earnest or the deposit of my salvation or my inheritance, which is now sealed by the Holy Ghost until the day of redemption. You understand that? He says you are sealed when you receive. So the Holy Spirit and Jesus and the Father, they are working in concert, in synergy for your salvation. You are not receiving something that comes only from God when you receive Jesus. When you receive Jesus, you're receiving the Father, you're receiving the Son, and you're receiving the Holy Spirit. But now he is saying to us, you got to bump up your relationship with the Holy Spirit because I'm going away. That you knew about me, he's talking to his disciples, that you could wake up in the morning and I was there and we were eating together and having fish sandwiches together and doing miracles together, now I must go. But for your advantage, I'm sending the Holy Spirit. And he is called the Spirit of Truth. And he's going to lead you in truth. So whatever you need to know, whatever it is that you're confused about, it won't be me that brings the information. He's going to take from what is mine and he is going to make it known unto you. All that is mine that the Father has given me, now the Holy Spirit will make it known to you. You've had me for 3 years and everything that the Father needed to tell you, he told you through me, but I'm going away. And the advantage that you will have is that the Father and I will now be in heaven, but the Holy Spirit will be in the earth. And because he's in the earth and he operates between the earth and heaven, he knows what is going on in heaven. He knows the mysteries. He knows the secrets. He will take from what he hears from me and make it known unto you. Wow. Wow. How powerful is that? What do you say? You don't have to be baffled. You don't have to be confused. You don't have to be up a tree without any type of solution. You mean to tell me that the Holy Spirit has been given to me for my advantage? Wow. And then this is the part I want you to hear. Verse 14. He will glorify me, for he will take from what is mine and declare it unto you. Listen, believer, there is no rivalry. There is no competition between the Holy Spirit and Jesus and the Father. Listen, this is what the Holy Spirit said to me today. He said, stop making a rivalry when it's none. Hallelujah. There is none. So you don't have to feel that, oh my God, my loyalty to Jesus is now compromised because I now am engaging the Holy Spirit. There is no rivalry. The Holy Spirit glorifies Jesus. Jesus glorifies the Father, and the Father glorifies us. Are you catching that? Did you understand what I said? This is great. I know you're shouting because I feel like shouting right now. So you put in a shout for me. Listen to this. The Holy Spirit glorifies Jesus. That means he makes him big. He makes him look good. Hallelujah. He sets the stage for him. Jesus glorifies the Father. Jesus always makes the Father look good. But then the Father glorifies us, the believer. Oh my God, if you're not saved, you need to get saved right now so you can get the advantage of having a relationship with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
If you have enjoyed the teaching on the Holy Spirit by Bishop Vaughn, you will want to learn more, and we have just the products to help you in your quest. The Day of Pentecost, a powerful 4-disc set on the origin of Pentecost, the value of Pentecost today, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and living in the third day. Have you received the Holy Ghost since you believed, or help you through the baptism of the Holy Spirit and living daily life with the Holy Spirit as your most intimate companion? There's a Flow CD is the music ministry by Bishop Vaughn that will help create an atmosphere of meditation and worship. It also includes a powerful exhortation of the Word with signs and miracles. If you are interested in these product offers, for a gift to our ministry of $50 or more, we will ship them out to you, and you will be blessed indeed. Go to our website at www.gotellit.org or call 313-579-2800 now. You may also send your request by mail to Bishop Corletta Vaughn, 1745 East Grand Boulevard, Detroit, Michigan 48211.